Now the next question is, if z is equal to minus 1 plus I root 3 and n is an integer, then prove that z raised to 2n plus 2 raised to n z raised to n plus 2 raised to 2n is equal to 0 if n is not a multiple of 3. So here the given complex number is in Cartesian form and we have been asked to prove this result, that is, addition of these three terms is equal to 0. So what we'll do is, we will first find answer of each term, then we will substitute answer of each term on the left hand side, and then we'll check whether we are getting 0 or not. So here z is given as minus 1 plus I root 3. Now if I'll try to find out the first term, that is z raised to 2n, it means power of complex number. So using Cartesian form, it is not possible, because according to de Moivre, if you want to find power, the number has to be in polar form. So what we'll do, we will convert the given number in polar form. So from this number, we can easily say that x is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to root 3. So as x is negative and y is positive, this number belongs to second quadrant, right? Because here x is negative and y is positive. So this complex number lies in second quadrant. Now we'll start to find modulus and then argument so that we can convert the given number in polar form. So to find modulus, that is r, the formula is square root of x square plus y square. Here x is minus 1, so square of minus 1 is 1, plus y square, y is root 3, root 3 square is 3, yes, so it becomes 4, and square root of 4 is 2. So here we will get r equal to 2. Now next step, we will find theta, that is argument of this complex number z. So the formula is tan inverse y by x. So according to formula, it becomes tan inverse of root 3 upon minus 1, that is minus root 3. Now as per the formula, tan inverse of minus theta, it is minus tan inverse theta. I can write it as minus tan inverse of root 3. Next, what is tan inverse of root 3? So from table, tan inverse of root 3 is 60 degree, that is pi by 3. So we will write answer as minus pi by 3. So we got theta. Now as the given number lies in second quadrant, we have seen one rule that whenever number lies in second quadrant, you need to add pi in it to get your argument of z. So here I am adding pi in the answer. So minus pi by 3 plus pi will give me 2 pi by 3. And this is the answer of your argument. Now what is next step? After this, we'll convert the number in polar form. So therefore, z becomes, the polar form is r into cos theta plus I sin theta. So what is r? R is 2. What is theta? It is 2 pi by 3. So cos 2 pi by 3 plus I sin 2 pi by 3. So this is the polar form of complex number. Now we will start with the answer. So in LHS we have three terms. What I'll do is, I'll find first term. So first term is z raised to 2n. So what I'll do is, I'll take 2n power of this complex number z. So therefore it will be 2 raised to 2n inside bracket cos टू पाई बाय थ्री प्लस आई साइन टू पाई बाय थ्री होल रेस टू टू एन. Now here we can apply de Moivre's theorem. So by de Moivre's we will get 2 raised to 2n into cos of 2n will come inside and it will become 4n pi by 3 plus I sin 4n pi by 3. Now this is value of first term. Now we will find second term. Now second term is 2 raised to n into z raised to n. So since 2 raised to n is a constant, we won't consider it. We will find z raised to n. So therefore, z raised to n, similarly, by de Moivre's, it will become 2 raised to n and this bracket raised to n, where n will come inside by de Moivre's, and we will get cos of 2n pi by 3 plus I sin 2n pi by 3. So, we got first two terms. Now, the last term is 2 raised to 2n, which is again a constant, so no need to find. So, ultimately, we got values of all three terms. Now, we will consider LHS. Then, we will substitute values of these three terms in LHS. And let's see whether we are getting 0 or not if n is not a multiple of 3.